Hello students, good morning and welcome to another lecture of physics. This is our fifth lecture on magnetism and matter. And in this lecture also, we are going to solve examples based on the topic which we have discussed. Like what we have done in our last video lecture. Right. So, let us quickly revise the topic which we are going to use. Right. There are formulas which will be required. So, let us quickly revise those things. We have discussed that the torque acting on a magnet. It may be a bar magnet or solenoid. That's why I'm not specifying that. The torque acting on a bar magnet or a solenoid is given as torque equal to M cross B, or its magnitude you can write torque equal to MB sin theta. Now, if theta is 0, torque will be 0. If theta is 90 degree, torque will be maximum. That all that we have already discussed. Right. Second thing is, the potential energy of the dipole kept in a uniform magnetic field will be minus m dot b or mb cos theta. This will be the potential energy. If the dipole is kept in a uniform magnetic field and if it is displaced from its equilibrium position, suppose we have a bar magnet which is kept in a uniform magnetic field, or let us say a solenoid which is kept in a uniform magnetic field and is displaced from its equilibrium position and released, then it will start performing simple harmonic motion SHM, and the period of such oscillation is T is equal to 2 pi under root I by mb under root I by mb, where here this I is moment of inertia. Remember, here we are not writing capital I because capital I is for current, as well as we are not writing small I because small I represents imaginary current or complex current, which you are going to learn in chapter 7. So something different symbol for moment of inertia we have taken. Apart from this, let us say, what is the magnetic dipole moment M? For a solenoid, magnetic dipole moment M is given as INA, INA, where I is current, N is number of turns, and A is area. So the magnetic dipole moment of a solenoid is given as INA, you can say INA, where I is for electric current, N is number of turns, and A is cross-sectional area. The fifth formula which you should remember, and the most important one, is magnetic field along the axis of a bar magnet. Suppose if we draw a bar magnet somewhere over here, right, then the line which is passing through bar magnet, this line will be known as axis of the bar magnet. Right. So if you want to find magnetic field at some point B, then this point will be B of axis. Here the magnetic field will be known as B of axis. The magnetic field at point B will be the magnetic field related to the axis of the bar magnet. In the same way, if we consider a line which is passing through a bar magnet but perpendicular to its length, then it is known as equatorial line. Right? And suppose if we select some point over here, let us say Q, then at this point the magnetic field will be B of equator. B of axis and B of equator. So for B of axis, we have formula mu 0 over 4 pi 2 m by r cube. Remember, we have here considered that r is much more greater than the length of the bar magnet. The total length of the bar magnet is 2l. This total length will be 2l, and this distance r is from the center of the bar magnet. Suppose at point P, you can say that this will be the distance l. Sorry, this will be the distance r, right, and this is l. From center to one of the end of the bar magnet, the distance is l, and from center to the point where we want to find magnetic field will be distance r. So if r is much more greater than l, then we have formula for B of x is equal to mu 0 over 4 pi 2 m by r cube. In the same way, you can say that B of equator at equatorial point will be mu 0 over 4 pi m by r cube. Right. Again, the condition is r is much more greater than l. Now remember, if I same for both this, you can say that b of x is 2 times b of equator. B of x is 2 times b of equator. Here mu 0 is known as magnetic permeability. Mu 0 is permeability, and its value is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7, and unit is Tesla meter per ampere. Its unit is Tesla meter per ampere. There are two more units of mu naught, right? That is magnetic permeability. You can easily obtain those two formula. One relation you are having, that is speed of light c is equal to 1 over under root mu 0 epsilon 0. You know this formula, that c is equal to 1 over under root mu naught epsilon naught. So square this equation, make mu naught subject and find the value or find a unit. Right? You can easily find unit of this. So with the help of this, try to obtain another unit for mu naught. Now, these are the formulas which we are going to use in our this video lecture in order to solve few example based on it. So let us start solving example based on these concepts. So just keep all these formulas in mind. If you want, you can write down this formula on a page, and we are going to start solving examples, right? In this lecture, we are going to solve unsolved example 8, 5.8, 5.9, 5.12. Remember, in last lecture we have solved up to 5.7. from 5.3 unsolved example 5.3 to unsolved example 5.7. and in this lecture we are going to continue our discussion. So we'll solve from exercise 5.89 and so on. So let us start solving. So the first one is unsolved example 5.8. or exercise 5.8. A closely wound solenoid, a closely wound solenoid of 2000 turns, a closely wound solenoid of 2000 turns and area of cross section and area of cross section 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 4 meters square, carrying a current of 4 ampere is suspended through its center, allowing it to turn in a horizontal, allowing it to turn in a horizontal plane A. What is the magnetic moment associated with the solenoid? And the second one B, what is the force and torque on the solenoid if a uniform magnetic field field if a uniform horizontal magnetic field if a uniform horizontal magnetic field of 7.5 into 10 to the power minus 2 Tesla is set up at an angle is set up at an angle of 30 degree with the axis of the solenoid. Now in this example you can see that it is given that we have a closely wound solenoid of 2000 turns. So number of turns are given as 2000. Let us start making list. So here N is given as given number of turns N is equal to 2000 and area of cross section that is A is given as 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 4 meters square. Carrying a current of this solenoid is carrying a current of 4 ampere. The current flowing through the solenoid is 4 ampere. Is suspended through its center, allowing it to turn in the horizontal plane. It is suspended means it is hanged from its horizontal, from its center. It is hanged from its center so that it can easily rotate in the horizontal plane, right? What is the magnetic moment associated with it? So in our first question A, we have to find magnetic moment of a solenoid. That is magnetic dipole moment of a solenoid. So just now only we have written the formula for magnetic dipole moment of a solenoid is R and A in R. Right. So here I is 4, number of turns is 2000 and area is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 4. So 1.6 into 8000 will be equal to 12800 into 10 to the power minus 4. If you shift point, you will get 1.28 ampere meter square. Right, now in second case, in case B, what is the force and torque on the solenoid if the uniform horizontal magnetic field B is given as 7.5 into 10 to the power minus 2 Tesla is set up at an angle of 30 degree. Angle theta is given as 30 degree with the axis of the solenoid. What is the force and torque? Remember, you have come across this in chapter 1. You have come across this in chapter 1 that when an electric dipole is kept in a uniform electric field, the net force acting on it is always zero. Exactly in the same, when a power magnet is kept in a uniform magnetic field, the net force acting on it will always be zero because two equal and opposite force will act on it, which will produce a torque, right? So two forces will act on it which are equal in magnitude as well as opposite in direction. Let us say for example, suppose we have uniform electric field, right? Let us say this is uniform electric field and an electric dipole is kept in it. So for electric dipole, let us say this will be plus Q charge and this will be minus Q charge. Let us say uniform electric field is E. Now in this case, the force acting on plus Q charge will be, what will be the force acting on plus Q charge? So if you draw the direction of plus force on plus Q charge, it will be in this direction, right? Because electric field starts from positive to negative. So you can say that here negative charge is there. So negative field is there, right? So it will get attracted towards the negative. So this will be F, let us say 1, which will be equal to plus QE. In the same way, here the force will be acting in this direction. Let us say it is F2, which is equal to minus QE. Now if you add both these forces, so F1 plus F2 will be QE plus minus QE. QE minus QE will be 0. So you can say that the net force acting on an electric dipole kept in a uniform magnetic electric field will always be 0. In the same way, if a magnetic dipole is kept in a uniform magnetic field, then also the force will be zero. Let us say instead of this charge, we have pole strength, right? We already discussed, instead of charge, we have pole strength. So let us say P into P. And here we will have P into P, which is negative. P into P, which is negative. So obviously, this is Qm if you want to write. Qm or small p represents magnetic pole strength, which is similar to that of charge. The role played by magnetic pole strength is exactly similar to the role played by charge in an electric field. So instead of charge, I have written Qm. You can write P also. So both thing here we have written. You can write Qm. So here it should be Qmb minus Qm. So minus Qmb. Right. If you want to write P, then plus Pb and here minus Pb. So if you add these two, the net force will always be zero. Clear? So what we can write over here? Therefore, we can say that for a solenoid kept in uniform magnetic field, the force, that is the net force acting on it, is always zero. So the force acting on it will be zero. You can say that F is zero. Now, what is formula for torque? So torque equal to mb sine theta. Right, so here for solenoid we are adding ms. Msb is sine theta. Now magnetic dipole moment for solenoid we have calculated as 1.28 into magnetic field is 7.5 into 10 to the power minus 2 into sine 30. Right, into sine 30. So if you multiply 1.28 into 7.5, let us multiply this. 1.28 into 7.5 will give 9.6. And sine 30 is half. Let us write first. This is 9.6 into 10 to the power minus 2 into sine 30 is half. So divide by 2 will be 4.8. So this will be 4.8 into 10 to the power minus 2 newton meter. So this will be the torque acting on this solenoid kept in a uniform magnetic field. Now let us discuss another unsolved example 5.9. So unsolved example 5.9. Unsolved example 5.9, or you can say that exercise 5.9. Now in this example it is given that a circular coil of 16 turns and radius 10 centimeter carrying a current of 0.75 ampere rest with its plane normal to an external field of magnitude, external magnetic field of magnitude 5.0 into 10 to the power minus 2 Tesla. The coil is free to rotate, or it is free to turn about an axis
coil is free to turn about its axis in its plane. Perpendicular to the field direction. Perpendicular to the field direction. When the coil is turned slightly. When the coil is turned slightly and released. When the coil is turned slightly and released, it oscillates about its stable equilibrium. With a frequency of 2 second inverse. What is the moment of inertia of the coil about its axis of rotation? What is the moment of inertia of the coil about its axis of rotation?
So in this example, you can see that it is given that we have a circular coil of 16 turns, right? A circular coil of 16 turns, and radius of the circular coil is given as 10 cm, which carries a current of 0.75 ampere. So 0.75 ampere is current is flowing through the coil. It is kept in rest with an external field. And external magnitude of external field is given as 5 into 10 to the power minus 2 Tesla. Now the coil is free to rotate about its axis. Suppose this is a coil which is kept in a uniform magnetic field. Now if we displace this coil slightly and release, then it will start performing oscillations. The frequency of such oscillation is also given, and we have to find moment of inertia. Right. So let us make list of given data. Given number of turns as 16. Radius is 10 cm, so that is 0.1 meter. Carries a current, I is given as 0.75 ampere. External magnetic field is 5.0 into 10 to the power minus 2 Tesla. The coil is free to turn on an axis in the plane perpendicular to the field direction. What is when the coil is turned slightly and released, it oscillates about its stable equilibrium with a frequency of, so frequency is given as 2 second inverse. What is moment of inertia of the coil? So we have to calculate moment of inertia. Again, we will revise the question. It is quite simple. We have a circular coil with some number of turns and it is carrying some current. Now it is placed in a uniform magnetic field so that it will attain its equilibrium, stable equilibrium, right? Now when you displace this coil, right, from its stable equilibrium, then you know that restoring torque will act on it, and because of this restoring torque, it will start oscillating in the field, and the oscillation will continue till it will come to the equilibrium position. So it will keep on oscillating. Here the frequency of oscillation is also given, and we have to find moment of inertia. So direct formula is that we know that T, time period of oscillation, is 2 pi under root I by MB. Squaring above equation. Why we are squaring it? Because we want to find moment of inertia I. So squaring above equation, you get T square will be equal to 4 pi square I by MB. So therefore, moment of inertia I will be equal to T square MB over 4 pi square. But T is not given. So, but T equal to 1 upon F, inverse of frequency is periodic time. So therefore, moment of inertia I will be equal to MB over 4 pi square, and T square is 1 by F square. So this will be F square. Now here M,
moment of inertia is not given. So moment of inertia is ni into a, ni a into b over 4 pi square f square. A coil having number of turns carrying current is nothing but a solenoid only. If we take a coil which has large number of closely wound turns, let us say large number means it may be 10, 20, okay, not necessarily always large number. So let us say we have a coil with some number of turns over it, right, and it is carrying current. So that coil is nothing but a solenoid. So for solenoid, magnetic dipole moment is NIA or INA, because magnetic dipole moment is INA. So INA. Also, what is formula for area of a circle, because it is a circular coil? Cross section area will be pi r square. So therefore, moment of inertia I will be equal to NI into area is pi r square b over 4 pi square f square. 1 pi will get cancelled. So therefore, moment of inertia I will be equal to N, number of turns, 16, into I, current is 0.75, into radius is 0.1, so 0.1 square, into magnetic field is 5 into 10 to the power minus 2, whole over 4, into pi is 3.14, into f is 2, so 2 square. So let us simplify this. So due to some technical issues, we were unable to record the last two steps of this calculation, right? Hota hai kabhi kabhi ho jata hai, usme kya, right? So what we are going to do, we are going to solve it now. Let us solve this. So 16d into 0.75 into 0.1 into 0.1 into 5 divided by 4 divided by 2 square is 4 divided by 3.14. So the answer will be 0.0119 into 10 to the power minus 2. You shift 1-2 point, right? So you can say that 1.19 into 10 to the power minus 4, or if you want to write, you can nearly like 1.20 into 10 to the power minus 4 kg meter square. This will be the value of moment of inertia. Okay. So now our next example will be unsolved example 5.12, right? So unsolved example 5.12. Now in this example, let us write question first. What is given? A short bar magnet has a magnetic moment, or you can say the magnetic dipole moment of 0.48 joule per tesla. Give the direction and magnitude of the magnetic field produced by the magnet at a distance of 10 centimeter from the center of the magnet. On A, the axis, and B, the equatorial lines of the magnet.
So you can see that in this example, it is given that we have a short bar magnet having magnetic moment or magnetic dipole moment. So let us make a list of given data. Given magnetic dipole moment M is equal to 0.48 ampere meter square or joule per Tesla, right? Give the direction and magnitude of magnetic field. That is, we have to find magnetic field at a distance of 10 cm. R is given as 10 cm, that is 0.1 meter from the center of the bar magnet. Quite a simple example. We have given a bar magnet whose magnetic dipole moment is given to us, right? And we have to find magnetic field at a distance of 10 cm at two different locations. One along the axis and the second one is at the equatorial point. So let us consider first one. We have to find magnetic field along the axis of a bar magnet, right? Along the axis means, let us say this is the bar magnet. If this is the bar magnet, then from its center we have to find magnetic field at some point P, which is at a distance 0.1 meter. Right. So at this point we have to find magnetic field, and this is along the axis, right? So this is the point P. You can say that the point P is along the axis of the bar magnet. We know that magnetic field along the axis of a bar magnet is given as mu naught over 4 pi 2 m by r cube. Mu naught over 4 pi 2 m by r cube. Right. So this will be equal to mu naught is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7 over 4 pi into 2. Magnetic moment is 0.48 over 0.1 cube. You can easily simplify this, right? 4 pi will get cancelled. Therefore, B of x will be equal to 10 to the power minus 7 into 2 into 0.48. 48 into 2 is 96. So you can say that this is 0.96. 4 over 0.1 cube is 10 is to minus 1 cube. So you can say that 10 to the power minus 3. So if this 10 to the power minus 3 will move up, so 10 to the power minus 7 plus 3 will be minus 4. So you will get 0.96 into 10 to the power minus 4 Tesla. If you want, you can write this as 0.96 Gauss. This will be the answer of magnetic field along the axis of a bar magnet. Now the second thing which we have to calculate is magnetic field at the equatorial point. So be at equator, right? So we know that magnetic field along the equatorial point, let us say if this is a bar magnet, if this is the bar magnet, then from the center if we consider a point P over here, then this point which is perpendicular to the length of the bar magnet will be known as its equatorial point, right? And this distance is given as R. We want to find magnetic field at this point. So we have formula B of equator is mu naught over 4 pi m by r cube. Mu naught over 4 pi m by r cube. So this will be equal to mu naught. Value of mu naught is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7 over 4 pi into. Value of m is 0.48 and r is 0.1 cube. So 4 pi will get cancelled out. So you will have 10 to the power minus 7 into 0.48, actually your bracket should be there, whole cube, right? And 0.1 cube is 10 to the power minus 3. So this will be equal to 0.48, 10 to the power minus 7, and this will move up, so plus 3, so into 10 to the power minus 4 Tesla, or you can write 0.48 Gauss. Now here you can easily see that if R is same, you can see that for both the cases, value of R is same. Here also it is 10 cm, in that case also 10 cm. So in our one of the video lecture, we have discussed that if R is same, then magnetic field along the axis of a bar magnet will be twice the magnetic field along the equatorial point. You can easily verify. Magnetic field along the axis is 0.96 Gauss, and magnetic field at equator is 0.48 Gauss. If you multiply 0.48 by 2,
it will become 0.96. So hence we can say that magnetic field along the axis is 2 times magnetic field along the equator if R is same. Now we have to find the direction of magnetic field. You can see here it is given that give the direction and magnitude of the magnetic field. So magnitude we have already calculated, right? Magnitude along the axis is 0.96 cos and magnitude along the equator is 0.48 cos. But what about its direction? We have to find direction also. So here you can see that for this bar magnet, if this is the north pole and this is the south pole, then this will be the direction of magnetic field. So you can see that the magnetic field is from south to north, right? So in this case we can say that B of axis is along south to north direction. South to north direction. Now for this, if we consider this as north and this as south, then obviously magnetic field line will move from north and will be in this direction from south. So at this point, magnetic field will be in this direction, right? You can see magnetic field lines emerges from north pole of the magnet and will move towards the south pole. So at this point, if you draw a tangent, the direction of magnetic field will be from north to south. You can see in this direction it is. This is the direction of magnetic field at point P. So for this case, we can say that B of equator, that is magnetic field along the equatorial point, is along north to south direction. Is along north to south direction. Clear? So these are the three examples which we have discussed in our this video lecture, and in our next video lecture we are going to discuss about an important topic, most important topic, in order to understand that, right? Lots of MCQs can be formed from those topics. So till then, keep on writing, keep on preparing and keep on reading. Thank you.